Welcome to Logan's Crossroads, an Ultimate General Civil War, playing the Union in the JMP mod. At 1st Division, I have two Napoleon batteries, one 24-pound howitzer, and two ordnance rifles, which are the same as my last battle. In 2nd and 3rd Divisions, I've moved my skirmishers to 2nd Corps to sit this one out, and I created two more infantry, which are Brooks and Henselman. When the battle starts, I set up in a V formation with two infantry and two guns facing in each direction. Your reserves come in pretty quick, so you don't have to wait that long. Tell me if this sounds familiar. You start a new battle, you place your infantry in cover, and you move up your smoothbores right behind them. Your rifled guns are just behind those. You send out scouts of any kind to locate the enemy artillery. You use your rifled guns to counter battery the enemy guns while your infantry and smoothbores hold off any charges. Once the enemy guns are destroyed, you mobilize your forces since they have no artillery support, and you do, and you kill off the enemy. That was the normal gameplay for most players in version 127 of the mod. That style of play has challenges in version 128 of the mod. First, the timing for battles and phases has been truncated throughout the game, so you don't have time to sit and wait until the enemy guns are gone to start mobilization. Second, everyone is aware that the accuracy perks dropped from 50% to 35%, but not many people noticed that most rifled guns had their damage reduced an additional 10%. So rifled guns do less damage, and they have less time to do their work. Third, since the division size is now 5 rather than 6, you have to do some downsizing, and that might actually mean less guns. One strategy that's starting to possibly lean towards a new meta is twofold. First, using cavalry as your primary anti-battery weapons rather than rifled guns. Second, using more smoothbore guns for support, especially in battles that now require the player to hold the VP or take a VP quicker due to shorter mission times. Rifled guns still have a place in the game, but they are no longer the primary offensive weapon. Rifled guns are most effective now for collapsing fortifications and anti-battery, not for destroying large quantities of troops. Hindsight is always 20/20, and I tend to play one grand battle ahead of whatever I'm posting on a given week. So as I'm posting everything through Shiloh this week, I'm actually playing around with different ways to play Gaines' Mill. I have reconfigured part of my army at Gaines' Mill to focus on smoothbores and cav support. I'm posting my original Logan's Crossroads battle here that I recorded for this campaign, but in hindsight I would have changed the following. First, I would start the battle with my 4 best infantry and 4 smoothbore guns. In this battle, I have a combination of both smoothbore and rifled. Second, in the first third to half of the Union campaign, I would take the horse artillery perk for all of my smoothbores and the shot shell perk for my rifled guns. Gameplay seems to support the conclusion that smoothbore effectiveness doesn't drop off that much when taking horse artillery versus the double canister perk. However, taking the horse artillery perk over shot shell for your rifled guns results in a noticeable difference. Your rifled guns really need that first perk. So with the need to rapidly deploy or fall back with smoothbore artillery at battles such as Distress Call, Shiloh, Gaines' Mill, and Malvern Hill, my advice would be to give all your smoothbores the horse artillery perk. Third, make liberal use of your detached skirmishers. I do not do a very good job of it here, but they make a noticeable difference in your results. And lastly, I have melee perked units here and still waver most of the CSA units when they charge before they actually get into melee. But if you find that you're getting into melee or you just want to try to capture more units, you could toss a melee perk onto a general and use him as a corps commander just for this battle.